Hey, what's going on? Welcome back to Daz React, and today I have an 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown reaction video for you. And I was doing these when the channel first started, and for whatever reason I stopped, but I don't know why, because I think they are absolutely hilarious, and I always want to watch more. I do watch them now and then on YouTube. I just don't react to them because some of them I have seen. But this come up on my recommended. This I wasn't meant to be doing this one today, but it came up on my recommended list, and I thought, you know what, I need a good laugh, and it's Joe Wilkinson, and this man honestly would never fail to make me laugh. Even just thinking about it now, he's making me laugh just thinking about him. And I ain't even seen what he's gonna do in this one. But this is Joe Wilkinson roasts everyone, and it's Mascot Madness, and I loved the program, and I love Joe Wilkinson, so I really am looking forward to this laugh.
Russian doll sets that I've painted.
What's going on there?
As you can see, Jimmy, you are the main Russian doll. You're in one of your swanky suits, but as you can see, you've pulled your trousers down and you've pushed your testicles out the side of your face. So, inside Jimmy is Rachel. As you can see, Rachel is holding some toilet rolls under her arm because she steals the toilet roll after the show when she's pissed up. Inside Rachel is Susie. Now, as you'll know, Susie's a pervert.
She's got a little camera with a naked picture of Joe.
As we all know, Susie's a pervert. bit of a peeping Tom, that's why she's wearing some binoculars and she's holding a Polaroid camera. The reason she's holding a Polaroid camera is because she does this thing where she'll kick your dressing room door down and try and take a picture of you when you're changing. I've spoken to HR, but they're scared of her temper. And then finally is John.
Well, you've done a life-size John.
Yeah, I feel that one sort of self-explanatory. As you can see, he's in his dinosaur pyjamas because he struggles to get adult clothes to fit. I have got a mascot, Jimmy. I've brought along a head cam because I get a lot of shit on this show. I brought along this head cam and it just...
Is this... These must be the ones that they've done during COVID. I have not seen any of these. I binged watched a few of the first seasons. But yeah, the ones that they've done through COVID. I don't know. There was no particular reason why I never watched them. I just never got round to watching them for whatever reason.
I brought along this head cam and it just, like, for example, if, like, Rachel spits at me or whatever, I'll have proof because they always cut it from the show.
Sorry, has that happened before? Does she...?
Yeah, but they never leave it in. So it's just for my own protection. And, you know, and it's good fun as well because there's lots of things you can do with it. You know, look about and people at home can see the crap I have to put up with. Have you ever wondered what it's like to get off a Sean Locke?
Yeah, I have always wondered.
Yeah, so you can do that. I thought I'd show you some stuff.
So this is the countdown set in close-up?
Down here. Oh, there's always forget. This is where Rachel has a little kit between the grounds. A few cans. God, that stinks. We need to burn that. Oh, yeah, she always leaves a message on the board for the crew. What else is there? Don't know what all this is. Is this usually here? Lots of bored-looking people. Oh, there's a cameraman having a piss. You animal. Oh, there was one thing I always think of showing people. You're like this. Down here, what people don't know, this is the door to John's dressing room. He's got the run of the whole desk. I've...
John gets so much fleck for his height, he honestly does.
I've bought one in my collection of Countdown indoor tropical water features. So there's all of us on here having a nice time. There's Sean. See Sean there? He's having a lovely time shouting at a pigeon.
I love, honestly, one thing that I loved about this, like, obviously when Sean was alive and he was doing this show, one thing is, like, Joe Wilkinson could always make this man laugh. The only other person that really made him laugh a lot on this show was himself. But Joe Wilkinson never, ever failed to make this man laugh.
John on holiday, yeah. he's slightly more body conscious than Sean. So he's wearing a T-shirt with no trousers and pants on. that's the only one that's life-size. here, we've got me, Susie and Rachel having a lovely time. And as you can see, Rachel's passed out on the back because she's been drinking all afternoon. And then, finally, we've got Jimmy here, lounging, having a lovely time, having a cocktail. Don't know why he's so happy. Absolutely no genitals. And the best bit about it, my favourite bit, is it's not actually water. It's Campari and lemonade. So, yeah.
What have you got?
Don't know yet. By the way, you two have got lovely bodies. what I've actually brought along is I brought along one of my parrots. I've got a load of parrots. And this one here is... chill out, Leslie, chill out! So, yeah, this particular one, so I've got 16, this one... Leslie, got off an East End gangster. That's why his perch is actually a sawn off. he's got a couple of lovely little, calm down! Knuckle dusters there. And instead of a cuttlefish, he likes to peck on a human ear.
Does he speak?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Fuck's talking to you, boy!
Sorry. I've seen this bit before. I was trying my hardest not to laugh. That bit always cracks me up.
Does he speak?
Yeah, unfortunately.
Talking to you, boy.
he's picked up a bit of bad language from the gangsters. So,
are we on that Countdown bollocks, boy?
Yeah, with the mascot. Yeah.
At least that little turd John ain't on this week.
No,
sorry, John, I didn't see you there, pal. Fuck me, small.
You gotta love it, honey.
Can see you there, pal. Fuck me, small. All right, Rachel. I see someone's knocked you up. Any idea who done it?
Can't really say that, mate.
Do you want me to go round his ass and cut his Jacobs?
Right, that'll do.
Sure, have you got a mascot?
I don't know about you, but I'm fed up with the same old piñatas. Aren't you?
Yes.
Fed up with it. So, I've come up with my own range of piñatas. I've brought a few with me. This first one is my Rachel Riley piñata. having a few cans and she's thrown up. and rather than do the old boring sweets,
inside the piñata, I decided to put something inside that the kids can whack out, something more relevant. So in this one, it's a load of marijuana joints. More relevant to Rachel. The next one is Susie Dent. As you can see, she's holding a bicycle chain, which is her pub fight weapon of choice.
Certainly is.
And inside is a dictionary. Oh. But in good in Susie Dent fashion, it's hiding a knuckle dust. this one's you, Jimmy.
That looks scary.
The hair comes off like that. Not the real thing. And inside is simply some teeth whitening gel for horses. Sean, here's Sean. He's got the traditional middle finger.
Hey!
Inside Sean, there's a load of little toys and trumpets and so on. That, things that bring you joy, but they're all broken. And finally is a John Pinata.
Do you know, if John's like self-conscious about his weight, then he doesn't need to be on this show. Honestly, half of that was just taking the piss out of John. I need to do more of these. I really do. That there's still a lot that I haven't seen from this show. I mean, probably like, I'd say like 70% of this I hadn't seen. I see the one with the parrot, that one I'd already seen, and I see the one with the water fountain. But other than that, I don't think I'd seen any more of these. So yeah, I do need to start watching more of these because they are hilarious. And Joe Wilkinson will always have me in stitches. I remember the first time I reacted to him. Though no, I've watched him do the his poem about like this, about naming the guy's penis next to you in the men's urinal at the train station. And that is something, it had me in tears, honestly. It is one of the funniest things that I have ever heard. And it was just incredible. But this show, I mean, Joe was hilarious when I first started watching it. But what drew me to this show was when I first started watching it was Sean Locke. And I think that's why now, it's not that I refuse to watch it. It's just that because Sean's not on it, it's almost like my brain won't let me switch it on. I don't know why, but it just won't. And it's wrong, obviously, I know, because it's still funny either way with the rest of them on there. But yeah, it's just not the same without Sean. So yeah, that I think that's why it never went back on. But guys, listen, thank you all for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this. If there is any other specific like 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown videos that you want me to react to, let me know in the comments down below and I will get round to doing it. But until then, thank you all for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this. Have a nice day and I'll see you in the next one.